Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss the problem C from the latest Code Forces round 686, problem name sequence transformation. So you can read the problem statement, but I'll tell you in simple terms. It states that you are given an array, as you can see, and then you will choose some x. X means that if you will choose some number which is inside this array. Let's assume that if I choose x equal to 1, then what you'll do, you will like delete some segments from this array such that the segment should not consist of x. So like I can make this as a segment, I can take this as a segment, I can take only these two elements as a segment. I cannot take this as a segment because I have chosen x equal to 1. So I have to take segments from this array and delete them such that the segment should not consist of like the x itself. So after deleting out all the segments except the segments consisting of x, we will only have the element x in the array. As you can see, if I choose x equal to 1, I can take out this array and I have to take out this segment. So after that, only the array consists of all the numbers equal to x only. So as you can see, so in this transformation, we have to take out you have taken out two segments. You can assume that I have taken out two segments, this segment and this segment. The total number of segments deleted is 2. If I chooses x equal to 3, then I have to delete this segment and this segment. I cannot choose a segment taking 3 in that segment. If I take segment equal to 2, or segment equal to 1, then I have to delete this and this. So what we have to do here is, you have to somehow choose an x such that if you take that x, you have to delete the minimum number of segments to reach the final state, which is the elements in the final state of the array consist of that x only. I hope you get the intuition, like the problem itself. We'll go through the test code so you will make it more clear. As you can see in this, if I choose x equal to 1, then I don't have to do anything. The answer is 0 because I don't have to do any operation. My operation consisting of choosing out some segment and deleting it such that the final answer or the final array should consist of only the number consisting of x. In this, if I choose somehow x equal to 1, then I can take this as a segment and delete it. If I choose x equal to 2, then I have to delete this and this. Then I have to do two operations. But if I choose x equal to 1, I have to do only one operation. If I choose x equal to 3, then I have to delete this and delete this. So it means that just delete out all the segments except the number itself. And then you have to count out how many segments you deleted in this operation. And thus, as you can see in this, the minimum is 1. Because if you take x equal to 1, then you don't have, like you just have to delete one segment. In this case, if you take x equal to 1, you can delete this segment. And then only the segment consisting of 1 will remain. If you choose x equal to 2, then you have to delete this, you have to delete this, you have to delete this. If you choose x equal to 3, you have to delete this. And this answer is 1 because if you choose x equal to 1, you have to just delete this. So I hope you understand the test cases and understand how this problem proceeds. You can pause this video and try to solve it out on your own. I'll take on to the code part, sorry, the explanation part. So we're gonna take this as example to make it even more clear. Yeah, so these are the numbers. Now, what is the simplest way is if we somehow store the indexes of the elements we have seen till now, then we can easily, because we can just always doing an O of N operation. If we somehow store the indexing of every number we have seen till now, then we can use those index places to find out how many segments I have to cut. I'll tell you how. Let's assume that we have seen 2 till now. So 2 is seen, and we just mark out the indexing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So because I've seen 2 at this index, I'm just storing out, or like you can make a map of vectors. So for every value, I'm making a vector and like storing out the frequency I've seen this. So 2 is seen at the 0th indexing. Then again, I'll go to the next point. Okay, 2 is again seen at the first index again. Then 1. So one is seen at the index 2, then 2. 2 again is seen at the index 3, then 3. So 3 is seen at the index 4, and then 2. 2 is again seen at the index 5. 1 is seen at the index 6. So this is 2. Then what next? 7. So this is 2 again. This is 3, so this is 8, and this is 1, so I have seen 1 at the index 9, and then this is 2, so I have seen again 2 at the index 10. Okay, so that's how we store out all the elements. Let's assume I put one more element 4, and I have seen 4 at the index 11. And that's how we store out the index of every element we have seen till now. Now this is stored in O of n operation. And what we can do, we can now iterate over these elements. So if I take x equal to 2, I know that it is seen at these index, and using this index we can find out how many cuts I how many segments I have to delete. Okay, if the first index is 0, like if I see 0 somewhere, then it means that there is no element on the left. You have to start at this point, 2. Okay, now if I've seen one index 1, so the we will always check for the current index, just check with the previous index. If the difference between these two index is equal to 1, then there is no element in between of them, so we don't do anything. So then check between 3 and 2, which means that it is seen between 3 and 1. So it means that there is some element between them, because 3 minus 1 is like 2, which means that there is one element between them, and thus you have to take this as a segment and delete it. So this, like, the counter segment will increase. Now always like do a conjugate subtraction between the current index and the previous index, and if the difference between them is greater than equal to 2, the answer is like increment the total number of segments we have to delete. So then we have to delete this. If 7 minus this, okay, I have to delete this. Like this is also, we have to delete this. And then we have to also check out that whether this 2 is the last index. If this 2 is not the last index, then there is some element to the right side of also after this, so I have to delete the last one. That one. And thus we can easily calculate in O of n how many segments we have to delete if I take x equal to 2. Then go to the next point and do the same thing. Because this is not the first index, we can always tell that there are some elements in front of it. So like, okay, now I have to take this segment, then subtract this from this, so there are some elements in between, so we'll delete them. Then there's also some element between them, so we'll delete them. And this is not the last index, so there's some elements after that, so we'll delete them. And then in just O of n operation, we can find out how many segments you have to delete. And then we have to just minimize the number of segments among all the answers. The corner cases is if, let's assume that there is only one segment, let's assume that there is some number 7 in between, then if 7 is in between, there is like the number occurs only one time. So if the number occurs only one time, we have to check how many elements. If this is the somehow middle element, then there is, if we want to choose x equal to this, then we have to delete this whole segment and this whole segment. If 7 is in the front point, then we have to just delete the whole segment, this part. If 7 is the last point, then we have to delete this as a whole part. Okay, and that's the, like, those are the corner cases. Else we will always do the same thing which I've told you. We just, like, for the first element, you have to check how many elements are on the left side of it. For the last element, how many elements are on the right side of it. And for the between elements, you have to check that. We have to just do a conjugative subtraction of the current element minus the previous number. If the difference is greater than or equal to 2, then we just increment that. Okay, we have to do a segment cut at that point. And that's the logic for this problem. We just have to minimize over all the possible answers. So I'll take it down to the code part now. So yeah, so this is the code. I can zoom it out. Yeah, so this is the solve function. This is n, this is a, and this is the map to store out the free, like the indexing. So we'll go from like left to right, store out the values in a and also the indexing in map. So for the ith x, we'll store the index. So it's a map of int and the vector. So if n equal to 1, which means that there is only one element, then the answer is 0, because we don't have to do any cuts. There is only one element and like no need to do any cut. So this is a, like a base case. Else, the length is initialized with a very large number because we have to minimize the length, like the total number of cuts. So the total number of segments we have to delete, such that the answer is, so we have to minimize, so this is a very large number. And then we'll iterate over the map. Map stores the, if I take this as a x, at which positions it is found. So that's what we are doing. OK stores how many segment will be cut if I choose this as an x. So I dot first will be the x and I dot second is a vector which shows the indexing. So I'll tell you there are like one corner cases if the size is equal to 1, which means that the number occurs only one time. So numbers occur only one time. So if the number is the first or the last element, so first or the last element, then the answer is just 1 because we have to just do one cut, or like one segment is whole as a cut. If the element is in between, then we have to do two cuts. And then we continue just for this case. Else, for every other case, what we'll do, if it is the first element, what we'll do, if it is the first element, then we have to do a cut at all the rest numbers. So sorry, if it is the first number, then as you can see, if j equal to 0, sorry, for j equal to 0, which means that the first index, we have to check that if the first index element is not the 0th element. If it is not the 0th element, then we have to increment the total number of segments we have to count. What I mean by this is, if I choose x equal to 1, which means that the first index of 1 is not the first index of the whole array, which means that there are some elements to the right side of it and we have to also cut this segment out. But if x equal to 2, and for x equal to 2, the first index which I've seen is 0, which means that this is 0, so this is the first element. And there are no elements to the right left side of it, so don't have to cut anything. And that's what we are checking here. 0 means that for the first element, if the first element I'm checking on, so let's assume that for x equal to 2 I'm checking on the first index for x equal to 2, which I have seen, if the first index I have seen is greater than or equal to 1, which means that this is a number which is in middle or in some between, this is not the first index, then we have to increment the count or OK, which is storing our total number of segments. So we have to take the left part also. And for all the other parts, what we have to do, if you're on the last side, you have to check that if it is the last index or not. If it is the last index, then there are no elements on the right side, else you have to also take the right side index also after cutting, which I've told you in the previous part. And for all the other parts, we have to find out the difference between the ith and the I minus 1, also as you can see, j and j minus 1. If it's greater than 1, then we have to also increment the total number of segments. And we have to just minimize the total number of segments among all the segments. And that's the logic for this problem. You can see the code in the description. And if you don't understand it, you can rewind this video or like rewatch it. I hope you get the intuition and the logic itself for the problem. If you still have any doubts, mention now. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.